this. Who do we have calling?
Keirstyn.
Hi, Keirstyn. I'm going to come over to the board. Keirstyn?
Yep.
All right. Give me an idea what that problem is. See if we can help you.
All right. It is parentheses.
Parentheses.
-5, close parentheses.
-5, close parentheses.
X. -3.
-3.
Parentheses.
Parentheses.
+6, close parentheses.
+6, close parentheses.
-2.
-2.
Parentheses.
Parentheses.
+1.
+1.
Close parentheses.
Okay.
=108.
Wow. That's pretty long. I almost ran out of space there. So what do you think? How do we start off with this problem?
Do distributive properties.
Okay, let's do distributive properties. What distributive properties has us do is this. I take this first term here, and I'm going to multiply it by that one. So I'm going to take a -5 times an x, and I get -5x. You agree?
Yes.
All right. Now here is pretty tricky. This second one is pretty tricky. A lot of kids will want to go 3 times x. But what you have to remember is that minus sign goes with that 3. So it's going to be -3 times x, and I get
-3x.
Very good. The second thing that I'm going to distribute is the -3 times the 6. -3 times 6 is going to give me what?
-18.
Very good. You're good at this. These negative distributive problems are pretty tricky. So again, I'm going to take the -2 here, and I'm going to distribute that, multiply that by the x, and I'm going to get, what am I going to get?
-2x.
Very good. And I've got a -2 I'm going to multiply by 1. And what do you think I'm going to get?
-2.
Right again. You've been right every time here. And that's equal to 108. Once we've got that far, what do you think our next step might be?
Subtract 8 from 20.
Subtract 8 from 20. We could do it that way. Here's what I like to do. I like to combine like terms. Your teacher tell you about how to combine like terms?
Yeah.
So let's look at all the x's. I have a -5x. I got a -3x, and I got a -2x. So if I'm going to add them all up, I got a -5x and a -3x. If I add those two together, I get minus how many x's?
10x.
Well, you're good. You're jumping ahead of me. -5 plus -3 plus -2 is -10x. So now, what numbers do I have left? A -18.
-18 and -2.
And if I combine them, what do I get?
20.
-20. And that's equal to 108. What do you think our next step might be?
Add 20 on both sides.
Very good. Your teacher, you need to let your teacher know you're doing a great job. So I'm going to add 20 to both sides. I'm going to bring straight down my -10x. -20 and +20, they do what?
Cancel.
They cancel each other out. 100 plus 20 is 128. Now what do you think we got to do?
Divide by -10.
You're really on top of this. I'm going to divide by negative 10 on the left side. And whatever I do on the left side, I got to do on the right side. My negative 10s cancel out. On the left-hand side, I get x. On the right-hand side, I get 128 divided by negative 10. Now, I don't know how your teacher wants you to write your answer or how far to go. At this point, we could divide the denominator into the numerator and get our answer. Notice we have a negative here. That's going to tell us that our answer is going to be negative, whatever we get. Okay? Now, if I take 10 into 128, 10 goes into 12 one time. 10 times 1 is 10. I'm going to subtract my 2 from 0 and get 2. Bring my 8 down. 10 goes into 28 two times, and I'm going to get 20. And I'm going to bring the 8 down. Now notice that 10 doesn't go into 8. So what am I going to have to do? I'm going to put a decimal here, add a 0, and bring that 0 down. 10 goes into 80 8 times, and that's going to be my answer. So when I solve that, x is equal to negative 12.8. I think you did an excellent job on that. And where are you calling in from?
West Monroe, New York.
What's your school?
Central Square Middle School.
All right. You did a great job today.
Thank you.